One place is a very good grower, and he was trying to spray three different blocks of trees with the same sprayer by changing the number of nozzles that he had on the sprayer. And what we did by running his calibrations was discover that he could get his sprayer calibration a lot closer if he just simply changed the location of where he put the nozzles. He had the big nozzles up top, and a lot of times he was turning off the volume that he wanted, and if he moved them to a different position on the boom, he would get a more even calibration across his blocks. I went to another small orchard operation where the owner had purchased a brand new sprayer from the dealership who gave him absolutely no instruction on how it worked, and he didn't know that he could turn off nozzles. And they'd adjusted it to put the largest nozzles at the very top of the spray manifold where they sprayed straight up into the air and didn't even hit the tree. So by simply rearranging his nozzles, we were able to get the spray coverage where it needed to be.
It's always interesting the other items that come up through doing calibration. You know, in this one orchard situation, they were pumping a sump and they didn't realize they were picking up foreign debris, as in gravel and some wood product that had accumulated in the sump pump area, and they pumped it into their sprayer to get rid of it, and they didn't realize what they were doing. So, you know, in that case, hey, maybe you should be checking your strainer more often when you did that right after it, so that those foreign particles don't get into the system itself. The level of maintenance on an orchard sprayer is critical, that you maintain your rubber gaskets, your goof valves, your diaphragms, the nozzles, making sure that they're all current and not 5 years and they dry rot and break.
And people know what they're doing, they know what they're putting out, they have a good idea, but little errors creep in. You know, the tractor tires have worn down since you calibrated the sprayer, so now your tractor's going a little slower than you think it is. Or your pump gets a little old and tired and your pressure isn't exactly what you think it is. I mean, sometimes we go to places and we find that their pressure gauge has stopped working and they just haven't bothered to fix it because it works fine, you know, we're doing fine, we don't need to fix it. Or one of the biggest things I find is that the nozzles that they think are in the sprayer are not the nozzles that are in the sprayer. They'll have dropped them in the middle of the night when they're spraying, and they'll just take one quick and stick it in so they can get the job done, and then they forget to go back and fix it and put the right nozzle in.
The other thing that's really critical that a lot of the growers during this week is they don't have the information written down. And to me, the most important thing during this week of working with the growers is having them write down that information so they have it from year to year. Or if somebody's sick, somebody in the operation knows how to operate it.
A lot of times people tell me that I don't need to change my calibration, I don't need to check my sprayer, because it's putting out exactly what it put out when I got it from the dealer. The dealer set it all up for me, and it was fine, and it's still spraying exactly the same, so it's obviously just right. And I would have to say that the dealer doesn't necessarily calibrate the sprayer with the precision that you want to have. The sprayer will ask you the speed of your tractor, he'll ask you your row width, and he'll ask you how much pressure the tractor's putting out, the sprayer is putting out. He then uses a little slide rule to calculate how many gallons per minute you want, and then he goes to his book and he figures out the nearest gallons per minute that the nozzles will be putting out to reach the rate that you want. I received a sprayer from that had been recalibrated by the dealer. It had all new nozzles on it, and it used to take me 4,000 gallons to spray the orchard. And when I recalibrated it, I could then cover the orchard using only 3,250 gallons, which is like a 15% savings. And it was a $40,000 spray bill, so 15% savings is a significant amount.
Okay, you feel that you're getting, let's show me. Let's see what it's doing it, and using the technology that we have today, and see what you're actually putting on. And it's a win-win situation.
Well, I'll say to growers, they'll say, well, I'm getting fine coverage now. And I'll look at them and say, if I could come up to your car and give you 4 more miles to the gallon, by simply making a few adjustments to your car, would you do that? And they'd go, yes. But so you say, I can get you more bang for your buck with your sprayer if you'll just follow this program and make a few adjustments to it. And then they say no. So I don't understand that.
We have newer materials coming out that are more specific. But these materials we're applying in ounces or parts of ounces per acre, and a 10% error with a material like that of applying too much is drops, versus a material that, you know, the common one that, you know, Cap 10, we're putting 2-3 pounds, maybe 4 pounds per acre, and we made a 10% error, we're talking about of a quarter of a pound to a half a pound. So you know, it's critical today that we're more precise in our applications because we're going to smaller finite amounts of materials, and it's easier to make more mistakes when we're dealing with smaller amounts. With the average farm up our way being around 50 acres of fruit trees, you know, and you start looking at how much those each individual nozzle cost. You know, a whirl plate with that little ceramic tip at the end, roughly $15, maybe $20. And, you know, you relate that to the orchard as, you know, that's one bushel of apples. You know, and one bushel of apples, and if they're pulling 300, 400 bushels, is that a cheap investment to make sure you're applying the proper amount of material on a tree? And, you know, before we looked at materials costing $5 an acre, now we're looking at materials costing $50 an acre. A 10% error all of a sudden is major dollars input. You know, some of the growers are looking upwards of, $2,000 an acre in a season of spraying, and a 10% error or mistake is $200 an acre, and that can add up. So, you know, if you're looking at your total spray bill, it makes a difference. So, you know, a boom that has 10 nozzles on it equals 10 bushels, and you're picking 5,000 bushels, pretty cheap investment to make sure you're applying what you need to be applying. You know, and that's what we're looking at, trying to keep the farmers in business and trying to get that competitive advantage.